The city council passed a controversial bag tax that was referred to by my colleague by, I think, a close vote, 28 to 20. And let me be clear. I think New Yorkers are tired of being insulted and lied to. The debate about the plastic bag tax, fee, charge, whatever you want to call it, has nothing to do with whether people care or don't care about the environment, or whether people care or don't care about climate change. That is not the issue. I don't believe there's anyone here that wants to hurt the environment. The issue is whether we have to be punitive every time that there is an issue. And that's the way things go regularly. If government doesn't have a way to fix something, no problem, tax. No problem, ticket. No problem, fine. So the bag tax was scheduled to be implemented this past October. There was a postponement. It's quite shocking to me, based on what the mayor just mentioned to the assembly member, why there would have been even a short postponement. It was supposed to be implemented in October, and instead it was postponed to February 15th. An overwhelming outcry of New Yorkers opposed being nickel and dimed and fined, and my colleagues and I introduced legislation to stop it. It was passed in June. Then New York City delayed it to February 15th, and it was common knowledge at the time that a commitment was made to the assembly by you and the New York City Council to use the 5-month intervening delay to make changes to the bag tax and possibly work towards a better solution to protect New Yorkers and the environment. Let's stop saying that the only way you can protect the environment or address climate change is by taxing people. Neither your office or the city council tried at all to work out a solution or a compromise. Strangely, no media coverage, no publicity on the implementation of the bag tax or a compromise to be worked out. Nothing. Until late last fall, notices were mailed to local retailers telling them, guess what? The tax is going into effect February 15th. The commitment made to work on a solution was yet another commitment ignored. We're now about 2 weeks away from a crisis facing average New Yorkers. And Mr. Mayor, I'm sure you're familiar with the saying, fool me once, shame on you, fool me twice, shame on me. So my question, Mr. Mayor, is, please set the record straight. What steps have you taken to eliminate, reform the onerous tax? And based on some of the comments you made earlier, it sounds like you don't want a postponement because you don't want to make any adjustments. Did your administration make any adjustments or attempts to approve this bill during the 5-month postponement that existed? I'm finished now.
Senator, I say this with deep respect, and we've known each other a long time and worked together a long time, but we just disagree very substantially on these matters. And I think it's respectful to be blunt about that disagreement. I fundamentally disagree that this is an issue that isn't urgent to address in terms of climate change. Our city, our state, our nation, we are so far behind right now where we need to be to protect our earth, and it's going to have devastating impacts if we don't address it on all levels. And what we saw with Sandy is just an example of things to come. So we must do this, and we have now even more urgency because we don't know whether the federal government's going to take a step backwards on addressing climate change. So I don't think there's any contradiction in saying to you that this is an urgent matter, as are a host of other things that we are trying to do simultaneously to address climate change. Second, as I said to the Assemblyman, we believe that a combination of public education and providing consumers with bags that they can use addresses this issue. And that was true for generations and generations. Plastic bags, as a common part of our society, is a few decades old. I do not believe it's a matter of unfairness to people to work us all away from plastic bags. And I believe if people have permanent bags, they don't need a plastic bag, they're not paying anything. And those permanent bags will be provided for free. A lot of people have them already. So it is about changing. All of us have to change our behavior in a lot of ways to address this new reality, or it will endanger us and our children and our grandchildren. So I believe that we said that from the beginning. The City Council initiated this, as I said, but we believe they were working in the right direction. And the two pillars of educating people and providing them with an alternative are how you address this issue. The one thing I know for sure is the status quo is not acceptable. If we continue using petroleum-based products on a mass scale when we don't need them, we're only exacerbating climate change. We're a very big market in New York City. We have a very big impact on the world, and it's our job to do it differently. On the special education question, Senator, we've had this conversation before. I will only say my instruction to all of my employees, whether in the Albany office or City Hall, is that when any member of the Senate or the Assembly have a concern, we need to be in dialogue with them immediately, whether it's a sit-down meeting, a phone call, a letter. I make that a priority, and I said in the beginning of my testimony, we appreciate all of the partnership we've had. If you believe there's a widespread belief among your colleagues that they are not given the proper communication, that's what you've heard. I've heard something very different from a lot of your colleagues. But if anyone here or any member of the Senate or Assembly feels they did not get the kind of response they deserve, I want to fix that. The instruction's been given, and I have plenty of evidence of the instruction being followed. And I don't know what's happening in the specific case of the communication between your office and my office, and we will work to fix that. But I disagree with you fundamentally on how far we have come on special education. I agreed energetically with the vision of addressing the original problem of our parents having to litigate for services they already deserved. This was something I worked on as public advocate. I appreciate your leadership, and I think we all got to a very good place several years ago that actually started real change, and I've heard from numerous parents, unsolicited, how much change has occurred in their lives. And then you further, I think appropriately, raised the issue of locking in three-year plans when there aren't any variations in the IEP or the programming to support the IEP, and I agreed to that, again, openly, energetically, and that is being implemented. Not all of it happens overnight, but it is being implemented. But I can tell you that we have specific evidence of moving consistently towards more and more cases being settled without litigation. That's the order I have given to our Department of Education, and we'll get you the chapter and verse on how that is moving. We also know there are some cases that are complex. That's a given. You said that too. I remember when you offered the point that you knew not every case was easy and that there would be cases where there would be a change in IEP or change in needs of a child year to year. But I agree with the vision you've laid out, and we are energetically implementing it. And I think there should be a battle of facts. I'm happy to have that battle of facts, and we will give you all of our information, chapter and verse, on what we're doing.
Well, first of all, I just want to address the chair. I know there's a time limit, but obviously the mayor didn't hear anything I said, because the first thing I said was that we're not debating whether to address climate change or whether to address the environment. The question is how to do it. That's the issue. Mr. Mayor, do you know how much a pound of bread costs today? Do you know how much a dozen eggs cost the regular family? Well, let me tell you, I was in this local shop a week ago, and a mother came in with a few children and put down whatever she wanted, and they did not have enough money, and the store owner said this was the price, and she had to put back sliced cheese. So again, the issue is not about protecting the environment. That's, everybody agrees, the crisis you mentioned very clearly. I never said it shouldn't be given priority. You know, when I got into this business, somebody said, when they ask you questions that you don't want to answer, you answer whatever you want. You don't have to talk about what they asked you. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about regular New Yorkers and why the city has to be punitive all the time. It's just not fair. Every poll has shown that most New Yorkers oppose a tax. The question here now is not whether we have to do something about the environment. Everyone agrees, no matter how many times I say it, you say it, everybody else, we are not going to make this debate about whether the environment is or is not important. It is, period. How do you get it done? Why can't it be positive? Why don't you give a nickel back to New Yorkers for every bag they don't use? A nickel back for a change. Reward positive behavior. Implement the law that exists. Force store owners to do what they're supposed to do for the last 10 years. Have recycling bins in front of the stores so that people can recycle it. What are we doing? We're not taking the nickel and putting it to protect the environment. We're giving the store owners another nickel profit. From who? From poor and middle class New Yorkers. So that's not protecting. Recycle. We educate. Give them back a nickel. Give them reusable bags. And what about incentivizing businesses? Patagonia uses recycled plastic to make clothes. Trex use recycled bags to make synthetic lumber. Why can't New York City? You talked about a mansion tax before. This is a mansion credit for the 1%. The mayor always talks about the 99%. Well, let me tell you, this is a 99% tax on the 99%. It's a credit for the 1%. Because the people who have limousines, chauffeurs, nannies are not dragging their groceries. They're getting them delivered or brought home by somebody else. It's irrational and it's punitive. The issue is not whether we want to do something or not do something. The issue is why New Yorkers have to be overtaxed, overfined, overticketed, and can't be treated like mature adults instead of like children who you decide you can't discipline any other way and smack them across the face over and over by charging them. It doesn't make sense. It doesn't make sense.
Thank you. Thank you, Senator Felder.